The person who chaired the committee on the same stuff.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I support what has been said by my brother, Honourable Member Mitheka Linturi. But, Speaker, when I got this information, I took it upon myself to get to know the background as to why this charge was preferred. And I was actually interested in getting to know the law under which they were charged. Mr. Speaker, what shocked me most is that the two Germans were not charged under the Kenyan laws. They were charged under law that is called the East African Community Customs Management Act of 2004. When I looked at that act, Mr. Speaker, section 202, it talks about carrying concealed goods. When you conceal goods, Mr. Speaker, they speak about packaging goods. What the information I got from the OCS Port Police Station was, Mr. Speaker, that these two Germans were carrying two suitcases that contained mugoka, and Mr. Speaker, you know what I mean by saying mugoka, and the other suitcase was carrying miraa. So, Mr. Speaker, what we are saying is that the Meru Nation is under persecution. Mr. Speaker, what that means is that any time a farmer grows and transports miraa to Mombasa or any other place, they are about to be charged by police officers. Mr. Speaker, the question I'm asking is this. The police officers have failed to look at the laws that apply in Kenya. They have decided, Mr. Speaker, to go to the East African community and get laws that they think can sustain a charge. The unfortunate bit, Mr. Speaker, is that these two were foreigners. But, Mr. Speaker, we cannot be making laws in this parliament and they are not being respected by the persons who are supposed to implement the law. The judiciary must take judicial notice of the fact that miraa is not illegal in Kenya. Whether you are consuming, whether you are planting, whether you are transporting, or whether you are treating it in any manner. So, Mr. Speaker, my plea to you today, because I speak here as a representative of the people of Meru County, who have not less than 500,000 votes. Mr. Speaker, time must come for this country to decide what it wants to do with the people of Meru in as far as miraa is concerned. Mr. Speaker, I'm asking the agencies that implement the law to take note of the fact that miraa is not a drug and to leave our people alone, because we feel very frustrated, we feel persecuted by the implementers of the law. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Point of information.